found it. Eleanor Rigby picks up the rice in the church where the wedding has been. She lives in a dream, stands at the window, wearing a face that she keeps in a jar by the door. Who is it for? All the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely people, where do they all belong? Father Mackenzie, writing the words to a sermon that no one would hear. No one comes near.
Henry, well, he looks okay. Has noted our mutual interest in romantic literature and would like to know if I've ever read Gone with the Wind. Yes. Why? Because if you met me, darling, your underwear would be gone with the wind. No, thank you.
Every Monday, me and my mate Tommy spend the day together. It's like our date night.
But we're not actually dating.
I know. We first met when we started school. We did everything together.
We played football for the same team.
Chased the same girl.
Visited the beach.
Had adventures in the woods.
Listened to the same music.
Saw the same films.
Played the same video games.
Drank in the same pubs.
Wore the same aftershave.
We spent the weekend in London.
We went camping in France.
We went on a lad's holiday.
We kissed the same girls.
At different times.
Of the day. They seem happy. I want that. I want someone who knows how to make me happy. Someone who makes me feel worth something.
This time I had to fight. I had to control the adrenaline, use it to motivate me into action. I got into the ambulance, and there we were, ready to save lives, making a difference, maybe only a ripple, but enough to make me...
Not the little heart. She's just trying to guilt trip me again.
It's not going to be a massive thing, just a few cheeky cocktails.
Oh, no, because then you'll want to go out and get hammered, and I'll be left on my own in the middle of a sticky floor club. And don't be stupid, Jane, you can't write that.
Right, I passed a couple of old ladies sat on the bench. I'd seen them before. I swear they never moved. I carried on up the main street towards the train station.
There's a level crossing just outside the station. It crosses the main road. It can be a bit of a pain disrupting the flow of traffic.
The barriers are coming down, so I have to play louder.
The alarm is blaring.
I heard this motorbike accelerating really quickly to try and make it through before the barriers came down.
The bike was on top of it.
And I heard it, a bang.
The rider and the bike came to an abrupt stop under the back end of the car.
People rushed over.
Cars stopped like dominoes, one after the other.
I could see him on the floor in front of me. He had skidded underneath the car.
That's caught in two minds for me to go over and help or stay put, worried my gear might get nicked.
People were phoning ambulances.
Some concerned the driver who just seconds earlier were waiting for the lights to change.
And then the next was involved in a horrific mess of jagged plastic and metal.
I felt helpless.
I checked his breathing.
Useless.
And pulse.
Like I had nothing to offer.
No breathing, no pulse.
The woman began filming what was happening. The resuscitation, the reactions of the crowd.
Why would a person do that?
The more I look at the video, the less and less real it becomes. I'm not sure if I should hand it in.
Should I say what I saw? I know it's not my responsibility, but it's the right thing to do, right?
Something is not right today. Well, something is more not right than usual.
So, it started off with whiskey, gin and rum, and was feeling good. Followed by brandy and vodka, and I'm starting to get wobbly. But after the Sambuca, I don't remember hearing the alarm anymore. To be honest, I don't remember a whole lot, but apparently I had John by the scruff of the neck telling why Colin was a shit name for a dog. Yeah, my boss didn't like that. He sent me straight home and told me not to come back the next day. So I didn't. And I haven't been back since. So, fuck him. Fuck the pub, fuck the job, fuck this place. I'm gonna go somewhere else. Yeah, I'm gonna go to New Zealand. Yeah, and if I go to New Zealand, I can start again. I can change my name, I can change my hair, I can change the way I dress, and nobody would know. I could make it up.
So, I have written a list of things that I want to achieve, in the hopes that moving them from the depths of my brain onto a piece of paper might actually help them come true. So here we go. Number one, make friends with the old couple upstairs. I'll buy them biscuits. Old people like biscuits, right? Number two, come up with conversational topics with which to approach said couple to avoid coming across as a creepy stalker. And number three, make a cuppa. Let's get that one crossed off now, shall we?
I need someone to come into my mind with a mop and just wipe away the dirt. I can't do that myself, not properly. It's like a stain on the carpet. There's a trick, a knack to getting it out, and I need someone to help me sort this mess out.
Look, I don't think I'm the sort who'd like to sit in the back of a charity shop sorting through people's smalls and socks, no matter how many. And I'm not really the one to stand in town rattling a tin. No, it's not me either. I need something where I can connect to people.
Oh, hello you. How are you?
Yeah, good thanks, Lee's right here.
Oh yeah, just leave them there, I'll pop them through to the kitchen in a bit.
Oh, it's no trouble.
Oh no, please, you don't worry yourself with that. You've done
it. Well, I can do it.
Well, I won't say no to that then. Do you know what's odd? We've probably racked up a good amount of time together since you've been delivering my shopping and I still don't know your name.
David.
Yes, I knew it!
What?
Nothing. I was just saying that you looked like a David. It's a nice name, that, isn't it? David. Nice, rugged name. David. And now I can't stop saying your name. And I'm so sorry, David. So sorry.
Lots of shopping this week.
Oh, yeah, well, I had a friend coming over, but she couldn't make it. What happens when you go and have children? No time for friends. So, now it's just me. Here, alone, with enough food for two.
We could freeze it.
I wonder if I've ever been watched without knowing, and if there's anyone watching that person watching me.
Or if there's someone who knows me, because I don't know
a vet. I wonder who's at the other end.
I wonder how many people feel alone when I do.
Eleanor Rigby died in a church and was buried along with her name. Nobody came. Father Mackenzie wiping her hands from the dirt as she walks from the grave. No one was saved. All the lonely people, where do they all come from? All the lonely